The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servers who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs in Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Perhaps you have heard or perhaps you have read the words of Saint Bernadette in the Cashew, where she said, when she was asked, why you? And she said, I am the most ignorant. Some writer said, the word was generous enough to describe herself, because some said the word she used was, I am the most stupid. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, after the time where Saint Bernadette stayed here in Lourdes, she went to Nubers and entered the monastery. She became nothing. She became no one. And if you asked the sisters, she only said the story about Lourdes in one way, in one time, and never been repeated. What is the invitation of today's celebration? Number one, you remember the words of Jesus about Saint John the Baptist. There is no one greater than John the Baptist. No one born of a woman greater than John the Baptist, but he is the least in the kingdom of heaven. If you seek greatness in this world, the standard is John the Baptist. But regardless how great John the Baptist, he is the least in the kingdom of heaven. To be great in the eyes of God is to be no one and to be nothing. To be poor among the poor, to be weak among the weak, to be sick among the sick. That is the opposite of what the world desires. What is the first reading trying to tell us? Be the light in a dark generation. The light don't have to be great. But when the world becomes dark, the darker it becomes, the light becomes greater. Habang dumidilim ang daigdig, kahit gaano kaliit ang ilaw, lalong nagliliwanag. Try to be the light. The second reading is what? Whatever you experience, whatever sufferings, whatever sickness, whatever mockery, name it, whatever humiliation, in the new heaven, all of these things will be forgotten. Will be forgotten. Many times I have said this, I rather be sick, go to heaven, than healthy, go to hell. I rather be poor, go to heaven, and be healthy, and be wealthy, go to hell. It is easier said than done. Honestly, it is easier said than done. When I was assigned in my first parish, the parish that I have been praying, Lord, sana wag akong ma-assign dyan. Wag akong ma-assign dyan. Lo and behold, doon ako nilagay ng Diyos. Doon ako nilagay ng Diyos. The first mass, walang gustong tumulong. Hindi ko makalimutan, ang first collection was 1850. Manila yan, 1999. 1850. Tatlong beses kong binilang ang collection. 1850 talaga. Umiyak ako, nakasalampak ako sa sahig. Tinitingnan ko ang butas na dingding dahil inuwi ng pari ang aircon. Tinitingnan ko ang lalagyan ng kama, na sahig lang dahil inuwi din ang kama. At sabi ko sa Diyos, ito ba ang kapalit ng iniwan kong trabaho? Umiiyak ako, nakatulog ako sa lungkot. Ang sinabi ko lang sa Diyos, Lord, please, don't make me poor, too poor that I may curse you. Don't make me too poor that I may curse you. But don't make me too rich that I might forget you. Don't make me too poor that I may curse you. Don't make me too rich that I may forget you. What is Saint Ignatius of Loyola trying to say? Seek no riches nor poverty. Seek no good health or sickness. Seek no popularity nor being destitute. Seek anything that will bring you to God. Kung anuman ang magdadala sa iyo tungo sa Diyos, yun ang piliin mo. Yun ang piliin mo. Kung pinayayaman ka ng Diyos at yun ang makakalapit sa iyo para sa Diyos, hari nawa yumamang ka. Kung ang pagkakaroon ng karamdaman ng maglalapit sa iyo sa Diyos, hari nawa magkasakit ka. Pero huwag kang mamimili. Huwag kang mamimili. Ang mahalaga, makarating tayo sa Diyos. Anong hamon sa Ebanghelyo? Mary points her finger to God. Do whatever He tells you. Anong tungkulin natin? Hanapin ang Diyos? Ituro ang Diyos sa ibang tao. A simple definition about evangelization is that we are poor, telling another poor where to find bread. That is our role. We are poor, we are among the beggars, telling another beggar where to find bread. We are not the bread. We will never become bread. But we can always point our fingers to God, telling everyone where to find bread. We are not the healer, but we can point our fingers to God who heals. We are not the provider, but we can always point our finger to God who provides. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, as I have said, what is important is we remain in God. Amen. In the silence of our hearts, I invite that you offer yourself to God. God don't need our money. God don't need our wealth, our success. God don't need our titles. God need our hearts. If God asks something from you, remember this, because there is something greater that He wants you to receive. Kung meron mang hinihingi sa iyo ang Diyos, ibigay mo, sapagkat merong higit na mas mabuti na gustong ibigay sa iyo ang Diyos. Just for your information, during the early days, the grotto was decorated with the many crutches, wheelchairs, symbolizing the many healing that took place in this place. But the church removed all these things because we are made to realize the purpose is not simply about healing, but drawing souls to God. Drawing souls to God. I'm not saying you don't pray for healing. I pray that you will find God. Pray in whatever situation, you will find God. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.